Well, guys, I'm officially the most happiest husband in the world. For a couple years, I've wanted to buy one of these false bottom setups for my mash tun, and my wife picked me up one for my birthday. Man, I can't wait to use this. It'll be really good for doing step mashes and everything. Won't have to worry about burning the grain or nothing. Right on, guys. Cheers.
Okay, guys, I'm kegging up the Imperial Stout. Now I've also cold steeped some 5 ounces of coffee grains. Let's see how this goes. There we go. We're adding it directly to the keg. Should give a nice fresh coffee flavor to it.
Okay, guys, this is the copper manifold that I used to use in my mash tun. Now we've got it all set up. Well, I'm quite excited for this. As you can see, it's got that there. The dip tube goes straight into there. Not sure if you can see that. I'm quite excited to give this a try. Probably going to do up another batch on Sunday. Give it a test run. Right on, guys. Cheers. Okay, guys, round two for the Hefeweizen yeast. Now this thing took off in about 2 to 3 hours when I pitched about 2 liters of wort into there. Going strong, getting ready for the brew day tomorrow. All right, boys and girls, well, I'm getting the mash all ready here, but I start sipping on the Russian Imperial Stout that I added the 5 ounces of cold steep coffee to. Turned out really nice. Check it out. Nice tan head on there. Give it a rum. Yeah, a lot of like roasted notes, kind of chocolatey. That's really smooth coffee flavors coming through. Oh, you can just barely smell the hops, but the coffee really stands out. That was when I was making the cold steep coffee, it turned out more like a thick extract. And then directly into the keg, just cooled it down to around what the temperature of the keg was, and I carved her up. All right, let's go for a taste. Cheers, and happy Homebrew Wednesday. Oh. Yeah, this beer really went beyond my expectations. It's 8%. You really don't taste any boozy character in it. A lot of people have been trying this and they've been telling me that it really goes down really smooth, really nice. It's got a really strong coffee, chocolate flavor. Oh, and the aroma, I just can't get over. Turned out pretty good, boys. I would highly suggest doing the cold mashed Russian Imperial Stout that I did. Then if you want, you know, maybe throw in some vanilla beans or some chocolate nibs, who knows what it would do to this beer, but the 5 ounces of the roasted coffee cold steeped, boy, turned out awesome. Cheers. Okay, guys, we got the system all set up now. As you can see, this is how I'm going to sparge now. And the inside with a new false bottom. The boil pot. Alright. Let's get this brew day started. Well, boys, I had a stuck mash, but I got her out of there with my pump. Now we're sitting at 168 for mash out. Now I thought this Norkel false bottom was supposed to prevent stuck mashes and everything, so I'm not sure what exactly happened. But I'm gonna do a little bit of reading and maybe I'll have to change this thing up a little bit. Well, boys, this is officially the brew day from hell. I had a second stuck mash during sparge. My pump just could not pump the wort out of this thing. So I'm gonna have to probably gonna have to do a little bit more reading on this false bottom, see if I can perfect it. I don't know, maybe put something around the dip tube or something like that. So sun's decided to come out. Looks like we're starting to get some great weather. It's going good. Brew gods are looking after me today, I guess. Sparge arm's working good. And as you can see, she's just barely coming through there. So it's a really slow process, but it's getting her done. Well, everyone, I figured it out. Now, what it was the dip tube is actually sticking right to the bottom of my my boil pot, or sorry, my mash tun. Now, that was keeping the flow from going through. When I was washing the false bottom, I filled the keg full of water, and it slowly came through just like it was with the wort. When I turned the dip tube to the left, it started going straight out. So, I don't know if anyone else has ever had that problem. I'm thinking about maybe drilling holes in the dip tube, or maybe cutting it shorter just so it's not touching the bottom. Maybe it'll get a better flow. Yeah, just let me know in the comments down below. Let me know if any of you guys with the same false bottom from NorCal has had this problem. But right on. We've collected all our wort now. Took about 3 hours, I think. We've got her all done now. I'm currently just filling up the mash tun again with some hot water left over from the sparge tank to clean it out. Oy. I'm just thankful I got it all out. Okay, we've reached the hot break. As you can see, it's dark out now. We're getting there. Well, everyone, a bunch of breweries actually just started opening up in Abbotsford. This was one of the first ones. Solitaire, that's what they named it. And guess what the brewery's named? Surly Brewing. Now I know there's one in the States there, and I really have no idea how they got away with this, but and how close it is, but there you go. Abbotsford's got a new brewery. Right on. Alright, I'd just like to send a shout out to Sam Larkman. I see he just gave me a shout out to one of his BrewTube videos. Here you go, buddy. Red Racer IPA. She is one fantastic IPA if you guys haven't tried it. Here we go, boys. Cheers.
All right, boys and girls, first top edition. Now it's been a 100-minute boil, and I'm putting in the first 60-minute hop edition. 30-minute hop edition. 10-minute hop edition.
Can see that, but I guess I hit 1047. Ugh. And here's our 10 gallons of the SJ Pour Competition beer. Hopefully, it'll taste good. I'll probably have to do this up again. At least we got her done. Happy Homebrew Wednesday, boys. Watch how Miss Annie at the counter.